Hello everyone. Now I am starting with series of YouTube lectures for computer organization and architecture. Today's topic is Von Neumann machine. Before I start, I request you to subscribe to channel Dev's Institute by clicking subscribe button given below the video and click on bell icon to get latest update and instant notification about the videos. Brief history of computer. The first computer made was ENIAC, that is Electronic Numerical Integrated and Computer, which was the world's first general purpose computer. This computer was made to be used by the US Army in World War. ENIAC machine was a decimal rather than a binary machine. ENIAC implementation was completed around in 1946. This was the world's first computer. Here we can see the picture of ENIAC machine. It was very huge in size. The weight of ENIAC machine was around 30 tons and space required was around 1500 square feet. It consists of vacuum tube. It has around 1800 vacuum tubes and requires 140 kilowatt of power. In short, it is a very huge machine requiring very high power as well as the space for the storage. ENIAC machine was having 20 accumulators where each accumulator can hold a 10 digit number. To represent 10 digit number, we have 1 digit of a number, we required 10 vacuum tubes. So, a ring of 10 vacuum tubes is used to represent a single digit. At a time, only one vacuum tube is on to represent one of the 10 digits. So, you have 10 vacuum tubes to represent one digit, and if you want to represent number 5, only 5th vacuum tube will be on and rest will be off. This is the way the numbers are stored in a accumulator or in a machine. That's why the size of the ENIAC machine was very huge. Here are some drawbacks of ENIAC machine. ENIAC machine has to be programmed manually. The task of entering and altering program was extremely tedious as program has to be entered manually through punch cards. The task of entering the program, or if you want to change some instructions of the program, then it was very difficult. Program is entered by setting switches and by plugging unplugging cables, because this is all about on and off of the vacuum tubes. Machine was not suitable to be used in war effort because it is not speedy. So it was used for a general purpose rather than to be used in a war. Next, to overcome the drawback of ENIAC machine, Von Neumann suggested a new technique called as a stored program concept. Von Neumann thought that instead of entering program, if a computer has a memory, then we can store program and data in the memory, and computer can access the data and instructions from there. So by this way, it is easy to write program and as well as it is easy to alter the program, because to alter the program only you need to modify some part of the memory and not the entire program is need to be modified or it needs to be entered again. A program can be set or altered easily by changing some of the values from the memory. The same idea was proposed by Alan Turing at about the same time. And in 1946, Von Neumann designed architecture for the same memory or for the same technique, and we call it as a IIS computer. So now we will see the structure of IIS computer. This is structure of IIS computer, which contains central processing unit, memory unit, input device and output device. If you think of any processor or any computer architecture in today's era also, this is the basic architecture, which contains CPU, memory, input device and output device. This is memory unit of a computer, which is responsible for storing data and instruction. Here in von Neumann architecture, a single memory unit is used to store data and instruction. But in Harvard architecture, a separate memory unit for data and instruction is used. This is the only difference between von Neumann architecture and Harvard architecture. Next block is arithmetic logical unit. This unit performs all arithmetic and logical operations. So basic of any of the program instruction is the arithmetic or logical operation. So separate part is required to perform this arithmetic or logical operation. Next is control unit. Control unit interprets instruction and causes them to execute. In short, control unit controls working of all of the elements of the processor. So by interpreting instruction, it gives instruction to ALU that which data is to be fetched from the memory, what operation is to be performed on the operands, and where the data is to be stored after operation is performed. Next is the input device. We need some device to transfer information from outside medium to the computer. So this is done through input device. So through input device we can send control signals or we can send data to memory unit and the central processing unit. Another one is the output device. So to whatever is the work done by computer or whatever is the output of the operation, that needs to be conveyed to output world, outside world. So this output device is used to convey the result or to transfer the information from computer to outside world. This is the basic structure of a IIS computer, which was designed by von Neumann. This is the memory structure of IIS computer. Each memory location consists of 40 bits. These bits are represented from 0 to 39. If the number is stored in the memory location, so the first bit, that is 0th bit, is used for the sign bit of the number, and rest, that is 39 bits, 1 to 39. These 39 bits are used to store the actual number. This is the structure if the data stored in a location is a number. But what if the data stored in the location is instruction? This is how the instruction is stored in the memory. Instruction, one instruction is of 20 bit and memory location is of 40 bit. So two instructions are stored simultaneously on a same memory location. So 0 to 19 bits, that is first 20 bits, are used to store left instruction, and 20 to 39, that is last 20 bits, are used to store the right instruction. In each instruction, first 8 bits are reserved for opcode and next 12 bits are reserved for the address. Opcode is nothing but the operation code, and same is the case with write instruction. So in a memory, a single memory location stores the two instructions in IIS computer. This is the detailed von Neumann architecture. What we have seen just now was the brief architecture, and this is the detailed architecture. Detailed architecture contains data processing unit, program control unit, and here is the input output equipment and the main memory. First block in program control unit is a PC. PC is the program counter. Program counter contains address of the next instruction to be executed. So when every time processor wants to execute instruction, the address of the instruction is taken from the program counter. Generally, the instructions are executed sequentially. So when one instruction is executed, program counter is automatically incremented by one, so that it will point to next instruction. Next block is MAR. This is the register which stores the memory address. We call it as a memory address register. So from program counter register, the address is taken into memory address register. Memory address register contains the address of the memory location at which we have to store the data or from which we have to read the data. So it is the address of memory location. The next is the memory buffer register. So what processor does? Address specified in the MAR is used to read the data or to write the data. And data which is read from the memory is stored in memory buffer register, or data to be stored in a memory is stored in memory buffer register. So you can call it, this is an intermediate register from the processor to memory. So whatever data we have to write to the memory is first stored in memory buffer register, and from memory buffer register it is transferred to main memory. And if the data is to be read from main memory, then data is read from main memory into memory buffer register, and from memory buffer register it is used by the ALU or it is transferred to input output device. So memory buffer register is the intermediate register to transfer data between the different parts of the memory, means from data processing unit to main memory, from main memory to data processing unit, or from IO to memory and from memory to IO. Next is the IR, that is instruction register. So when this MAR is used to read the instruction, instruction is read into MBR, that is upcode of the instruction is read into MBR, and from memory buffer register it is taken into IR, that is instruction register. Instruction register contains the latest opcode fetched by the processor. As we have seen earlier, a single memory location contains two instructions. So the left instruction is stored in IR and the right instruction is stored in IBR, that is instruction buffer register. So the latest instruction to be executed is present in IR and the next instruction to be executed is present in IBR, that is instruction buffer register. Buffer is nothing but the storage. So by reading this opcode or by interpreting opcode available in IR, control circuit generates the control signals to the various parts of the processor to perform the operation. The next is the data processing unit. The main element of data processing unit is arithmetic and logical unit. It is responsible for all arithmetic and logical operations. basic of any instruction is nothing but the arithmetic or logical operation. So to perform this operation, our ALU needs some register, and that we call it as a AC, that is accumulator, and MQ, that is multiplier quotient. So these registers are used to store the intermediate results of the operation. So again, ALU reads the operand from the MBR. Okay, so from main memory, data is taken into MBR, and ALU takes data from there. And to store intermediate result, it uses ALU and it uses accumulator and multiplier quotient. Why multiplier quotient is required? Because for some of the instructions like multiplication, a 240 bit number multiplication, here the size of accumulator is 40 bit because the memory size is 40 bit. So if you want to multiply 240 bit number, the result will be 80 bits. So to store 80 bit result, the most significant bits are stored in accumulator and least significant 40 bits are stored in multiplier quotient. Next block is the main memory, which we have seen earlier. Main memory contains the instruction and data, and these are the input output equipments which are responsible for reading data from external devices or writing data to external devices. So this is all about detailed von Neumann architecture. Thank you very much for listening my video. If you like my video, please press like button given below the video. If you have any doubts, you can ask me through comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to channel and click on bell icon for latest updates and more videos. Thank you.